Let's talk big picture now as we're trying to get a clearer read on the consumer as we move through the holiday shopping season. Steve Liesman has the results of the latest CNBC All-America survey. Also with us today is Francis Donald, Global Chief Economist and Strategist at Manulife Investment Management. Welcome to both of you. It's nice and cozy here all together. Steve, what are we learning?
Click, click, gift. That's what I'm saying today. After a two-year slump below the pandemic high, online shopping made a comeback this holiday season. Take a look at the numbers. CNBC All-America survey finding 57% of Americans naming online shopping as their top one or two destinations for Christmas gifts, up from 51% last year. Big box stores down 3 points to 18%. Non-chain store sales unchanged at 16%. 18% when we started. Look at this, Kelly.
Wow.
I think you had fewer kids. Maybe I had more hair when we first started asking this question. It was 18% back in 2006. And now look at that commandingly. You see that little dip there? They hit that the pandemic high, 50% down for 2 years, and now back above for a new high that we had. Those spending more include women age 50 plus, income lower than 30,000, no investments in the stock market, income 30 to 50,000, and those spending under $200. All that suggests to me that people may have glommed on online shopping, looking for bargains, keeping costs down amid inflation here. While Americans differ over how much they spend online, they don't much argue about where they spend, and you know the answer to this one. Amazon unchanged this year, 74%. Walmart did get up 4 points, but I don't know if you even call it a competitor. It's 16 points. Interesting to see the specialty goods stores like Etsy. And by the way, local websites also in that group there up by 6 points. 31% say they're going to use debt, which is kind of unchanged and really not a big deal in terms of the use of debt there. But that buy now, pay later, which is what Dominic was just talking about, 10% of all shoppers. We have not asked that question before, so we don't know how that compares comparatively, but not bad
sign of the
entry
times
for the first year. Courtney tells me she's been talking about this for 3 years and everybody's paying attention.
Well, I think after the Cyber Monday and Black Friday numbers, when that was the clear bright spot, and the question is whether these is just people kind of borrowing from the future in a bad trend, or, you know, just a different innovative way of using credit. So a lot
at a
of
time
mixed
when interest rates were super high. It's interesting to me. I don't know that I personally anymore think of online as a place to go for a bargain.
Yeah.
It's
Amazon's not that cheap.
Amazon's
sure.
But it's just like you do that to sort of see, well, is there a cheaper way to do it or a better way to do it? But it's also just a way to shop, convenience. It's not a directed way to shop.
Real quickly, then, before we bring Francis into this, then, would you say the takeaway from the All America survey is that consumers are feeling stretched or that they're feeling more flush this holiday
more
season?
Flush. The takeaway for me has been lousy views on the economy, but hearty spending plans.
Francis, what about you? I know you're a little bit more cautious, worried about a combo of things, the consumer being one of them.
There's still time left. You know, economists get pigeonholed into this economist or this recession or no recession view. We have a recession base case. Things can change. But more important is, when do you start trading that? We've just had a formidable pivot from the Fed. We have other central bankers trying to push back against that, but indicating no more rate hikes on the horizon. Inflation is slowing. The data is still strong. So we're in tactical Goldilocks, and two things can be true at the same time. You can be concerned about the recession ahead and know it's not yet time to trade it.
So remind me how long you've had this view that it was coming. So for instance, 2023 then was what kind of year?
Too long, Kelly. We've had this view for too long. And I think the big mistake that a lot of economists made in the 2023 recession call was not in saying, oh, this time's exactly the same. It was in actually thinking that the lags in the economy would be shorter. Mm. The average time that it takes for these rate hikes to work their way through is about 2 years. The make or break for this economy to really throw out that recession call, I need the next 3 to 6 months to not have a rise in the unemployment, to not see a consumer materially pull back, to not see CapEx decline. Now, expecting that to happen earlier, that was the mistake. Not recognizing how pro-cyclical fiscal would be, that's what landed a lot of economists in the 2023 recession camp. And if we're talking 6 months from now and we've not seen this develop, then yes, this time is remarkably different, Kelly, and we'll have to change our tune. But we have not yet seen that relationship between rates and the economy break just yet.